This is a video about sex bias in science, but to get there, we first need to talk about insect private parts. Like you do. I'm Anna, and this is Gross Science. Mantises are tricky to spot because they're masters of camouflage. But for mantis researchers, finding them is only the beginning. How do you distinguish one species from another, especially when they look so similar? Usually by looking at their penises.
How rude.
Well, sort of. Male mantises don't exactly have penises. They have these, a series of structures that help the male link up, hold on, and pass sperm to the ladies. Now, this strategy makes some sense. Male mantis parts do tend to be pretty conspicuous. But what about female mantises? Because of the focus on male genitalia, it's difficult to determine what species a lady mantis belongs to.
Who am I?
But for the first time, researchers decided to see if female genitalia could be used to tell praying mantis species apart. And what they found so far is that female genitals are indeed pretty different between groups.
So there.
In fact, by examining mantis lady parts, scientists just identified a whole new species. They described this praying mantis using the female's unique genitals, along with more traditional characteristics like where it lives, what it looks like, and yes, the male's genitals too. To honor this historic moment in mantis science, researchers named the insect Ilomantis ginsburgae, after Ruth Bader Ginsburg, the Supreme Court justice who's a champion for women's rights. This female-based research approach is one small step towards making our exploration of the tree of life more rigorous. Unfortunately, sex bias in research has an impact even closer to home. It affects medicine too. Male lab animals are used more often in research than females because females were thought to confound experiments with their pesky hormonal fluctuations.
Squeak.
Don't worry about Wanda, it's probably her time of the month.
Squeak.
But while studies in female mice suggest this concern is totally unfounded, the bias persisted for decades. For example, at least 63% of pharmaceutical drug studies surveyed from 2009 used only male mice. And many scientific studies haven't even bothered to list the sex of the animals at all. To fix this problem, the National Institutes of Health have just started requiring researchers to label the sex of their animals and to use females wherever appropriate. But rodents are only half the battle. Until recently, human females were also studied less than their male counterparts in medical research. Some scientists hypothesize that this bias might explain why people with two X chromosomes more often experience adverse effects from medicines than people with an X and a Y. It wasn't until 1993 that the NIH actually required that women and people of color be included as subjects in clinical trials. And by the way, inequalities in medicine based on race could and should be its own gross science video, so stay tuned. Anyway, there are many ways in which all humans are the same and require similar care. But where there are differences between people, whether they're based on sex or race or something else, it's important for us to study rather than ignore them. Otherwise, our medical system won't be able to adequately care for everyone. And that's gross. Ew. If you want to know more about sex bias in science, head over to Nova Next to check out Eben Bein's excellent article on the subject. I'll put a link in the description. And for more gross science, hit subscribe.